Whatever we can find. Yeah. You ain't gonna shoot that thing. You ain't got but two shells. Maybe one. And now here's a shot.
Maybe. But you won't. Cause it'll be through your skull and inside your brain before you can hear it. Hear it, you'll need a frontal lobe and things with names like Calliculus and Temporal Gyrus, and you won't have them anymore because they'll just be soup.
You a doctor?
Not anything.
You got a hurt man. It'd be worth your while.
You look at him again, I'll shoot you in the head.
That boy looks hungry. Why don't y'all come on in the truck? Get you something to eat. Ain't no need to be such a hard ass.
It seems like people are still fascinated with what the end of the world will look like. Will it be an Independence Day style alien invasion? There could be a day after tomorrow or 2012 type environmental disaster, a machine takeover like in the Matrix and Terminator series, or a disease and zombie combo like 29 Days Later or I Am Legend. In the world of The Road, based on the Pulitzer Prize winning book by Cormac McCarthy, you're never told exactly what causes the apocalypse, but as we follow a man and his son as they traverse a ruined American landscape searching for food and humans who won't kill them, one thing is for sure. No matter what causes it, the post-apocalypse is surely going to totally suck. Truly the most impressive thing about The Road is how this post-apocalyptic world has been realized. Beautifully shot by Javier Aguirre's robe, the landscape is painted in hues of mushy browns and grays, with no surviving plant or animal life, a perpetually rainy sky, and the decimated cars and buildings covered in a layer of ash. Almost all of the humans have been wiped out, and with the remaining ones resorting to cannibalism, you definitely want to avoid meeting any. It's through this gloomy, dangerous landscape that a father and young son who are never named, played by Viggo Mortensen and newcomer Cody Smit-McPhee, walk as they make their way to the coast with somewhat unfounded hopes of finding a friendly settlement there. Along the way, they scrounge for food, try to avoid thieves and gangs of cannibals, and keep alive the hope that they have retained any shred of human goodness worth saving. During their journey, we also see flashbacks of life before the fall, when the man was happily married to a woman played by Charlize Theron in the period right after the disaster, as she struggles to retain the will to live. The Road isn't a plot-oriented movie, so that's about all there is for story. The performances by Mortensen and Smit-McPhee are both excellent, adding to the film's realism and emotionally investing you in the horrific situation the father and son find themselves in. Across the board, practically every aspect of The Road is well executed, from the cinematography to the art direction to the costumes, which really look like they haven't been washed in years and are patched together with plastic bags and twine. But the weird thing is, I find The Road to be a hard film to recommend. The world that it takes place in is relentlessly bleak, where fear, starvation, and desperation inevitably bring out the worst in everybody. While this is totally fitting and realistic for the dying world portrayed in the movie and book, it can be extremely difficult, disturbing, and nerve-wracking to watch. There's nothing wrong with that, and as I said, the cinematic realization of this world is very impressive, but I don't think it's a world that many people are going to enjoy experiencing. And without much plot or character development, more sensitive viewers might be left wondering why they put themselves through such an ordeal. In an article for the Huffington Post, director John Hillcoat said he was perplexed by reviews that focused on how bleak The Road is, claiming that the book and the movie are meant to be optimistic, life-affirming, and a celebration of the love between a father and son. While all of those aspects are there, especially in the boy's belief that he and his father are the good guys tasked with keeping the fire of human kindness alive, you have to wade through some incredibly dark stuff to find it. And the idea that a father would do anything he can to protect his son when the other option is letting him be eaten by crazies doesn't seem like a very profound statement. But one message that does come through in The Road is that the future belongs to the children, and it's a parent's job to protect and prepare their kids so they're ready to inherit it. In this case, it's a future that looks pretty damn grim, but the optimism and resilience of young people is vital to any hopes that things could get better. The problem is that The Road does such a great job of showing you why the world is so horribly crappy that this optimism comes across more as being naive. And while it's true that some of the world's greatest achievements have come from people naive enough to believe that they could change things for the better, they might have felt different if everyone was trying to eat them. I'm Jonathan Kim, and this is a ReThink Review.